Hi guys, welcome back to my channel, or if you're new, thank you for visiting my channel. My name's Alyssa, and you should definitely stick around because we're gonna have fun together. Today's video is another one of my empties videos. I'm gonna kind of run you guys through products that I myself have run through within the past couple of months, and I'm gonna let you know if I think they are worth the purchase or not. So when I do these videos, I typically, sorry, my necklaces are like, oh, what is going on? Okay. So when I do these videos, I typically don't have a lot of makeup that I've run through, just because I'm sure you guys know it's kind of hard to run through makeup, unless if you're just using one item per category every single day. Like if you only have one concealer, obviously you're gonna go through that pretty fast, but I have kind of a variety of everything. So it takes me a long time to run through makeup. Usually I just have a lot of hair and skincare products. So yeah, that's kind of just a, like, I guess a disclaimer for what's gonna go on today. But I do have one makeup product, although it is not empty. I just wanted to warn you guys because this is really bad. So this is the Morphe Gel Eyeliner. And this is just their black one. It's in the shade Shadow, I guess. I thought it was called Slate. I think it's called Slate online, but the bottom of this is Shadow. So basically that eyeliner transfers like a mofo. I do have kind of more hooded eyes, but every single time I would wear it, it would transfer into my crease and it would just be really bad. And it was only like $12, but it's not even worth $12 because you can't wear it without it royally messing up your makeup. Although I do want to say, I know that they did relaunch their gel liners, so I'm not sure if there is a different formula in the ones that are currently available, but I kind of just wanted to throw out there. This one was really, really bad and I definitely would not repurchase it. Now we're going to move into hair. I have a couple different products. The first one is the Batiste Dry Shampoo in the Tropical scent. It's Coconut and Exotic Tropical. I got the big boy bottle because I use dry shampoo a lot because I'm lazy. This smells really good. It works really well. It was like $14 for the big can. I'm not sure how much the smaller size one is, but it's just a couple dollars cheaper. So I would definitely recommend that. I have my new bottle right here. So this is the empty one. This is my new one. So I have repurchased that and I would definitely recommend it if you're looking for a good dry shampoo, especially one that is not super expensive. The next two products I have are both like deep conditioners for the hair. The first one is a sample that I got. It is the brand Phyto Jojoba. I hope I'm saying it right. I'm not sure. It's a French brand, but it is their Intense Hydrating Brilliance Mask for Dry Hair. So this is what the little bottle looks like. As you can tell, I definitely used all of it. I actually really, really liked this. It smelled really, really, really good. It smelled kind of like fruity. I really liked the smell of it, and it did a really, really good job at moisturizing my hair. I've noticed that within the past year or so, my hair has kind of turned really, really dry. I used to have really, really hydrated hair, but more recently, it's just felt kind of drier. So I really, really enjoyed that, and if I could find it somewhere, I would probably repurchase it. I'm not sure how expensive it is, though. Let's do a little bit of research here. Let us find out. I don't remember if I got this from Ulta or Sephora. Like I said, it was a sample, so I think it might have been Sephora. No. Okay, it wasn't Sephora, so we'll try Ulta. Okay, so I can't find the exact mask. This one says it's the Intense Hydrating Brilliance Mask, and there's one on Ulta that is the Intense Nutrition Mask. They do not have the one that I have here, but it's $59 for a almost 7 ounce tub, so it is a little bit more pricey. I personally would not spend that much money on a conditioning mask because you can get this really great one from Aussie for like $5. I love this 3 minute moisture mask. It's the Aussie 3 minute miracle moist, 3 times moisture in 3 minutes deep conditioner. This is an 8 ounce bottle, so it would be the Phyto Jojoba one was 6.7 ounces, so you get 1.3 more ounces in this one. You save like $54? And this one works just as well, if not better. It also smells delicious. Do I need to say anything more about it? You can also get this one anywhere. I got this at the Kroger that I work at, so you can get it at the drugstore, at the grocery store. I'm pretty sure they probably carry it at Ulta. You can get that one anywhere. So I would recommend either one, but if you're more of a like balling on a budget type person, as I am, go with the Aussie one. The last hair care item that I have today is the Living Proof Fresh cut split end mender. So this is just a little sample size. I get these from Ulta quite often. I have a couple more in my cabinet right now. I liked this. I mean, I am really bad at noticing when things actually have an effect on my hair. I definitely don't feel like this had a bad effect. I don't really get split ends that easily, so I'm sure this did contribute to kind of keeping my hair and my ends more healthy. I have pretty healthy hair in the first place. If you're looking for something to kind of help with split ends, I would say go for it. I do know Living Proof is a tad bit more pricey. So it's $25 for the full size, which is 3.4 ounces. This one is 1 ounce, so you'd get quite a bit more for your money. I'd say it's worth $25. I have some other Living Proof products that I really like. If you're in the market for something to help with your split ends, I would say that this is a good product for that. I have two kind of like skincare for the body products, and then the rest of my products are all for the face. So I'll go ahead and do the body ones first. This first one is the Jergens Natural Glow Wet Skin Moisturizer, and this is for fair to medium skin tones. I got this as a sample as well. And this is basically meant to act as somewhat of a self-tanner inside the shower. So what you do is you finish showering, you turn off the water, and before you dry off your body, you apply this Jergens moisturizer. And basically it gives you like a subtle tan, more of a healthy glow type thing. I really liked it. It didn't really have that strong of a scent to me, which was something that was important because I know that self-tanners typically don't smell that great. It felt kind of weird to be like putting on a lotion onto wet skin and then drying off after. Now when you dry off, don't like rub with your towel, just kind of pat, you know? I liked it. I mean, I like Jergens products. It's not an obvious tan, it's more of a natural glow. So if you're just looking for something to kind of boost the radiance of your skin and give you a little bit more color, I would say that this is a really good product to have. And then the other body product that I have is the Sol Janeiro Brazilian Bum Bum Cream. Now, I had been dying to try this ever since I saw a video of Jamie Genevieve's using kind of the big tub of the Bum Bum Cream. I know that Tati and her husband James, they both really, really love the shower gel, so I was really excited to get this as a sample product. It smells delicious. It moisturizes your skin wonderfully. I would definitely, definitely, definitely purchase this, even though it is kind of pricey for the full size. It's like, I don't know, $25 for a tub of it, but I would definitely buy more things from this brand because I really, really, really liked this, and it smelled so good. All right, so I have a couple skincare products. I'm gonna just start with the one that's covered in cat hair, and I'm gonna ask you not to judge me because I have three cats and everything's covered in hair here, okay? So these are the Garnier Skin Active Charcoal Wipes, I think they are. They're the Garnier Skin Active Clean Plus Purifying Oil-Free Cleansing Towelettes that instantly draw out dirt, oil, and makeup and remove oil and mattify. They're oil-free, they're for oily skin, they've got charcoal in them, and there's 25 in the pack. That was a lot of information. So, when I first started using those, I really, really, really liked them. But the longer that I was using them, the less I started liking them. First of all, don't use those on your eyes because they will burn your eyes. They don't remove eye makeup that well, and they burn your eyes. So I would just avoid that. Secondly, they dried out really, really fast, which was something I wasn't expecting given that it has kind of the like better, more like plasticky closure type thing. But yeah, I wouldn't repurchase those. I think there are better makeup wipes on the market, especially considering that like the Neutrogena ones you can use on your eyes and they don't hurt your eyes. So I would pass on those. This Garnier product, however, I would not pass on. This is the Garnier Skin Active Micellar Cleansing Water. This one is for all skin types, although I have the one for oily skin now. So since I obviously said I have the one for oily skin now, I did repurchase this. It's like $8 for a bottle, but it lasts a really long time because you get 13 and a half ounces in this. It is literally as big as my head. I use this to take off my makeup after I have washed my face. So usually I go in with a cleansing oil or balm, and then I'll wash my face with a cleanser, and then I will take the micellar water and go over a final time to make sure that everything is removed, especially on my eyes. So I mostly use that to get off the remainder of my eye makeup, but like I said, I also kind of give one final sweep over my face just to make sure everything is gone. So I would recommend that. They have a couple different kinds. Like I said, that one is for all skin types. I have the oily skin one now, and they have like two other ones. So would definitely recommend that. And then speaking of cleansing balms, I am obsessed with this and I need more of it as soon as humanly possible. This is the Pharmacy Green Clean Makeup Melt Away Cleansing Balm. So this again was a sample product that I got, and I had never tried anything by Pharmacy before, but I have always been intrigued by the brand because they're all about natural nourishing ingredients and I'm all for that. I loved this. Not only did it work super, super well, but it has like the most like satisfying texture. It's like thick, but it melts in your hands and it just feels so good on the skin. And it smells so good. It smells like cucumbers and melon and fruit, and just it smells delicious. For a big tub of this, it is $34. Like I said, I do want to purchase it, but it is on the more pricey side. So it's something I'm kind of saving up for, but I would definitely recommend this. Even if you haven't used a cleansing balm before, you just use a cleansing balm or oil to kind of take off your makeup. It just melts everything down and like kind of separates it from your skin so that it comes off easier when you cleanse. So yeah, that is probably my favorite empty out of everything that I have to show you today. I also have this Ole Hendrickson Truth Serum. It says collagen boosted with Truth C complex. So this again is another little sample. I get tons of sample products like whenever I order anything from Ulta. This was okay. It smelled really good. It smells like citrus, but I don't necessarily feel like it was doing anything for my skin. Now, I was using a vitamin C serum at night and I was using this one in the morning, so maybe I was kind of just seeing the combined effects of that, but I don't think I would necessarily go out of my way to purchase this. I just don't feel like it did anything like dramatic for my skin. And then lastly, I have two moisturizers. One of them I really liked and would probably purchase, and then the other one I probably would not repurchase. So the one I wouldn't repurchase is the Derma E Firming DMAE Moisturizer. I got this from Ulta a while back and it took me a really long time to go through it. It was an okay moisturizer. I definitely would say that you could notice a firming difference, or like the firming effect that it had on the skin. Not only did my face look a little bit firmer, but it also physically felt firmer. I just don't feel like this did like everything I wanted it to do. So like while it did firm, it didn't really do anything to give my skin a really hydrated look or kind of combat dullness in my skin. It did what it said that it was going to do without having kind of any other moisturizing effects. So for that reason, I probably would not repurchase this. Although again, it wasn't bad. It did what it said it was gonna do. We didn't vibe. Then the last product I have is the Sunday Riley CEO C plus E Protect plus Repair Moisturizer. So again, this is a little sample. I really liked this. Again, it smelled like citrus. I've said this before, I really, really love skincare products that smell like citrus. It just makes my brain feel good and that makes my body feel good. So I did really enjoy this. It's kind of a thicker texture, which I like in a moisturizer. It made my skin really moisturized and it has a luminizing effect as well, which was noticeable. I do know that Sunday Riley though is quite expensive. So it's kind of like one of those treat yourself kinds of things. If you've got the money for it, I would recommend that. But if that is not in your budget, I would definitely say there are things that you can get at a cheaper price point that do a similar kind of thing for your skin. So yeah guys, those are all the empties that I have for today. Let me know if you have tried any of these products in the comments below and how they worked for you. Let me know what kind of empties you've been through this month. Give this video a thumbs up if you enjoyed it. Please subscribe before you leave if you haven't already, and I will see you in my next video. Bye.